No, the ongoing swarm of earthquakes in Japan, involving more than 100 instances of magnitude 3, 4, and 5 quakes, is not a sign that a major disaster is about to strike. You should ignore that viral claim saying otherwise, as major earthquakes with modern science cannot be predicted in any manner at the present. In truth, we actually don't know why this strong earthquake swarm is occurring, which is one reason why it's so interesting to us scientists. As a result, the rest of this video will contain almost pure opinion and speculation, albeit speculation from a geologist, so take everything with a grain of salt. Normally, a typical earthquake sequence involves a main shock and then a general 1 over x rate, with x representing time for aftershocks that strike. In contrast, what is ongoing in the Tokara Islands does not fit this profile, seemingly defying the expected trend. The sequence instead represents what is known as an earthquake swarm. Earthquake swarms are unusual and can occur when one of the following processes happen: an intrusion of magma, the movement of sizable hydrothermal fluids, a very sticky and slowly moving fault, and carbon dioxide-rich fluids that aren't specifically magma, rising from an underlying body of magma. Any of these explanations could theoretically be the source of the still ongoing earthquake swarm. However, the ongoing earthquake swarm near Kodakarajima Island is not a completely new phenomenon, as similar intensity swarms have struck 3 additional times in the exact same location since 2021 began. These occurred during April 2021, December 2021, and September 2023. This repetition suggests a similar cause for each of these swarms. The latest earthquake swarm began on June 21, 2025, seemingly peaked between the 22nd and the 23rd, and has slowly declined ever since. All of these earthquakes are occurring seemingly along two trends, a normal fault striking to the northwest and a strike slip fault striking to the north. These quakes are occurring within an area of geologically young volcanoes, specifically the Ryukyu volcanic arc, meaning, in my opinion, the ongoing swarm is likely related to magma in some form. The first, less likely possibility is that the main focus of earthquakes, the northwest to southeast trend, represents seismic activity associated with the formation and expansion of a deep magma dike in the intermediate depth local crust, possibly at 12 kilometers depth. If this were to be the case, it almost certainly would not result in a volcanic eruption nearby, given its lack of vertical movement upwards. An argument against this is that no volcanic eruptions have been dated to within the last 50,000 years within 40 kilometers of the earthquake swarm. However, this does not prevent two possibilities. Possibility 1. There are many magmatic intrusions that end up failing, which occur in relative isolation away from a known volcanic system. Possibility 2, there could be a very deep magma chamber present, undetected, and these can exist for up to hundreds of thousands of years without completely cooling. Expanding on possibility 2 leads me to what I interpret is the most likely explanation for the ongoing earthquake swarm. In the last century, Japan has been the site of several strong earthquake swarms that have caused scientists to debate whether they were magmatic or purely hydrothermal in origin. Well, it turns out that at least in one of these prior swarms, the 1998 Haida Mountain Swarm, that the true culprit was a mixture of the two theories. There likely was a deep magma chamber degassing substantial carbon dioxide upwards, and its presence caused hydrothermal fluids to rise. This rise caused some measurable uplift, and then for new springs to appear on the surface which release much of this water. I personally interpret this same process to be the most likely cause of the repeated Kodakarajima Island adjacent earthquake swarm since 2021. So, once again, don't cancel any planned trips to Japan because of wrongful ongoing rumors. It is quite sad to see a real-world actual reduction in planned tourism this summer to Japan because of these rumors. The ongoing earthquake swarm can't trigger a megathrust, they're literally in the wrong location to do this. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel member Donald Saunders for upgrading their membership tier to support my work.